In this screencast, we choose a correlation for the Nusselt number, where the Nusselt number is equal to H times the characteristic length divided by the thermal conductivity of the fluid. And this Nusselt number is chosen depending on the geometry as well as the conditions of the particular situation. From the Nusselt number, we're able to calculate an H, and from the H, we're able to solve for the Biot number, and from the Biot number, we can decide which method we can use to solve for a transient problem. So here we have a gold sphere with a 50 millimeter diameter, and it's dropped into a water bath. We have an initial sphere temperature as well as a centerline temperature, which is expected to be 310 Kelvin. So how do we know that this is a transient problem? Well, one of the things that can tell us is this word initially. Anytime you see initially or the expression how long, you can assume that it is a transient problem. For a sphere, there's only one correlation for the Nusselt number, which makes our life a little easier. This is what's known as the Whitaker correlation. It is a function of both the Reynolds number as well as the Crandall number. Here's our plan. The first thing that we're going to do is look up the properties, because in order to solve for the Reynolds number, we're going to need properties. And for this particular correlation, the properties are looked up at the temperature of the bath, or what we call T infinity. Then we'll be able to solve for the Reynolds number. Once we have the Reynolds number, we're going to use our correlation so that we can solve for the Nusselt number. Once we have the Nusselt number, we can find our convective heat transfer coefficient. Then we're going to use H to find the Biot number. Then when we have our Biot number, this will tell us what method we need to use to solve for our time. Let's start by finding the properties at the temperature of the water bath, which is, if we take a look back here, 290 Kelvin. So here are the properties that we're going to need to calculate the Reynolds number. And the Reynolds number is the density times the velocity times the diameter divided by the viscosity. So based on the problem statement as well as these properties, we come out with a Reynolds number that equals 92,513. Now we can use the Whitaker correlation. And this correlation says that the Nusselt number is equal to 2 plus 0.4 Reynolds to the 1/2 plus 0.06 Reynolds to the 2/3. This is multiplied by Crandall number to the 0.4. And finally, this entire thing is multiplied by the viscosity divided by the viscosity at the surface raised to the 1/4. So when we put in our Reynolds number that we calculated as well as the Crandall number that we looked up, we end up with a Nusselt number that equals 822. This allows us to find our H, which is the Nusselt number, times the thermal conductivity of the fluid, divided by the diameter, our h is going to equal 9,830 watts per meter squared Kelvin. Now we have to check the VO number, which is equal to our h times the radius divided by 3. When we check the Biot number, the characteristic length for a sphere is r divided by 3. And this is divided by the thermal conductivity of the gold. And we end up with a Biot number of 0.2584. This is larger than 0.1, so we need to use an analytical solution. Note that when we've done transient problems before, we've always been given the H, or the convective heat transfer coefficient. Here we use our knowledge of Nusselt number correlations and the geometry and properties of our particular situation to find that H for ourselves.